From the previous quiz, the problem is that the variable I that's used in this thread creation operation is a globally visible variable that's defined in main. When its value changes in one thread, every one of the other threads will see the new value. In this particular case, the second thread that was created in pthread create was created with I equal 1. In the thread function, P will become equivalent to the address of I, and my num will then become equivalent to the actual value of I, so that's presumably 1. However, it is possible that before this thread had a chance to execute these operations and set the value of my num to be 1, the main thread went into the next iteration of this for loop, and there it incremented I, so I is now 2. Since we pass as an argument the address of I, P will also correspond to the address of I, so it will point to the same I, and then my num will actually take as a value the new value of I, so it will take as a value 2. So it's not like we lost the printout from that second thread that we were expecting would print out thread number 1. It's just that both the second and the third thread ended up seeing that the value of I is 2, and that's why they ended up printing out thread number 2. We call this situation a data race or a race condition. It occurs when one thread tries to read a variable that another thread is modifying. In this example, the second thread that we created was trying to read the variable I, and we were expecting it that it would read I equal 1. However, at the same time, the main thread was modifying I, was incrementing it, and it became 2. To correct the problem, let's look at a slightly modified code here. We see that in the for loop in main, the value of I is first copied into an array, into an element of an array, tnum. The array has as many elements as there are threads, and when we're creating a thread, we pass as an argument the address of the particular element of the array that corresponds to that thread number. By creating this array, then, it's like as if we created local storage or private storage for the arguments of every single one of the threads that we create. Now we don't have to worry about the ordering of how the new threads will execute the operations, because every one of them will have their own private copy of the input arguments that won't change.